sure feels like we've reached the top of the earth. And the trip begins in Warminster, Pennsylvania, on the regional rail line.
Stop 11-12 Morgan. Amtrak 30 is going to be the final stop for this train. Jefferson Station, main stop.
We're in Jefferson Station awaiting our train to Philadelphia International Airport.
Who says payphones don't exist anymore?
Southwest, 21:26, 6:50 p.m. at Philadelphia International, awaiting our flight to Denver, and I guess it's as good of a time as any to introduce you to my brother Tommy. What's up, Tommy?
That's our plane, which we'll be boarding shortly. Go get the rental car.
Yeah, find out where the rental car is. It's close.
We have to take a train back to get to the spot to get our rental car. Working behind the counter here at the rental car was just infatuated with the basketball game on TV. Just kept looking up at it. Constant distraction as the line built up, but whatever. We're here, we're happy.
To the basket. Terrific execution. But look, the second chance.
We reached our home sweet Holiday Inn. We will be staying the next few days. This place is it's a little different than the Holiday Inns I've been in the past. Pretty interesting. So, that was weird. Tommy, what just happened?
The room was occupied.
Open the door and there's a freaking deadbolt and some guy just like, what the hell are you doing?
Good thing it's deadbolt.
Bizarre. Yeah. We're still trying to get our room. We've been traveling all freaking day and all we want to do is just get the room and just you know, settle down, put our stuff down, watch some TV, get a good night's sleep, and then hopefully do a bunch of stuff tomorrow. We're still trying to sort this out, so it's insane. Attempt number two. Hopefully it's not some jackass in his underwear. Hello? Anyone in here? I think we're good. If we can find a freaking light. Alright, hotel room without someone in it. Good morning from Colorado. It's noisy as hell right outside our room. They give you this little perch or whatever, small little balcony, and it is so loud because we're right above all this stuff. So that's not great. But inside the room, you can't hear it, so it's not much of a problem. Didn't bother eating dinner last night. By the time we're done with the travel, a little tired, so taking a walk to grab some breakfast right about now.
Trying to catch your breath in the Rocky Mountain air.
Yeah, the altitude hasn't bothered me much, but, you know, we'll see after doing a 10-minute walk.
We're out for breakfast, and it is loud as can be. The one thing I can say from the early portion of this trip is every place is loud. The airplane was loud, the freaking hotel is loud, and this place is loud. So, hopefully it's good.
Breakfast time, and it's strawberry waffles. Tommy's got himself a... What's this sandwich called? What?
Let's do a tie.
Yeah, Ty's sandwich. What is in that thing?
Egg, cheddar, and avocado.
Egg, cheddar, and avocado.
On our way to Golden, Colorado. Tommy just ran right back to the room. He forgot the key to the rental car. So, we'll actually be on our way to Golden, Colorado in a matter of moments. We are going to check out the Coors Brewing Company, so that should be a lot of fun.
Only took an hour, but finally reached the front of the line.
To Miller Coors today. Now on our way over to the brewery, I'm going to take you on a short trip through Golden and give you a little bit of history and also point out some landmarks.
The worst case scenario for the store is a few free samples of beer, so why not do it?
That is an old beer can. Free sample number one.
No, wait till we're leaving.
How is it?
Kind of what you'd expect.
It's Coors.
Is that a lot of beer there? Sounds like a lot of beer.
Free sample round two. Tommy got some Killians. I went with the Blue Moon.
Just finished the Coors tour. Nothing earth shattering, but definitely a fun time. Worth doing if you're ever in Golden, Colorado.
Pizza looks good. We'll see if it is.
I approve. It was good. Whenever you're from Philadelphia or New York and those areas, you kind of are hesitant with pizza in other areas. At least I am, because I've had some experiences where I'm like, ooh, not great. Thank you. fun in Golden, Colorado. Right now, getting ready to head out to Dodgers Rockies in Coors Field. Really excited for the Dodgers and Rockies.
Follow the course of the road for 3 miles.
Follow the course of the road for 3 miles. Thanks, pal. Headed to Coors Field right now, Dodgers Rockies. Really excited to see a new ballpark. And as a Phillies fan, you got to be excited for an opportunity to see Chase Utley play.
This dude's just selling a truck full of oranges.
Coors Field. The parking situation at Coors Field is not great.
You emptied inside the ballpark.
Made it to Coors Field. Had some issues getting in. Took my little selfie stick, as they called it. It's really just a handler for the GoPro to make it possible to hold. Crazy gusts of wind right now. Dodgers are taking BP. The wind gusts are insane. I don't even know if this is picking up sound. I can't even hold the camera.
I just finished watching the batting practice. It was pretty non-eventful to the end. Adrian Gonzalez stepped up, hitting some pretty deep, but they're all upper deck, and we were here right field in the first deck, so they're all way over our head.
Ton of Dodgers fans here at Coors Field to see the Dodgers and Rockies. What's the deal with these skies? Not a fan. Out in center field at Coors Field, this stadium is massive. It's a beautiful ballpark. It is huge. 50,000 seats, which is probably completely unnecessary for this park. But hey, it's really nice. This might be the best deal I've ever seen at a stadium. All you can eat, frozen yogurt and toppings. What do you think of that?
Piled high.
Creative. Top of Coors Field.
Yeah, ready Thursday.
Just on the 5 minutes. These purple seats represent the 1 mile mark above sea level.
Let's play ball. Leading off the top half of the first inning for the Dodgers, second baseman number 26, Chase Utley.
The bottom of the third, Dodgers are up 3-0, so we'll see how things play out.
Mega nachos.
The first 5 innings of Kenta Maeda has been damn near perfect.
Kike Hernandez just made an amazing play out left field. Phillies with a 10-6 win tonight. What's in the water in Milwaukee? 10 runs? If they score 4 or 5, it's enough.
Bottom of the ninth here, 4-1 Dodgers, Rockies' last chance. We'll see what happens.
We're on video. He thinks this is a perfect picture.
The Dodgers win it 4-1 over Colorado. It was an enjoyable game. Got to see Kenta Maeda pitch really well. Got to see Chase Utley get 3 hits. Utley made the last out.
No, that's right.
Well, he fielded the last out.
Utley,
Utley hit took, the second.
Utley took
second.
Part in the last out, so... For the day, gonna go try and see some parks, see some of the outdoors. Hopefully things clear up. Skies are again kind of overcast. Not what I was hoping for or expecting out of Denver. Hoping for those bright blue skies, but should be a fun time. Stop today is another trip to Golden, Colorado. Came yesterday. It was a beautiful looking little town. Unfortunately, due to the brewery tour, didn't have a lot of time to spend there. Really wanted to take another look at the town. I wanted to have a chance to go up to Lookout Mountain, which you can see why now I wanted to do that. It's a really cool view, but it's also really cold up here. The consistent winds, which you can hear, I'm sure, are just kind of whipping around. Time to go visit Buffalo Bill. Going on, we're really high above sea level, as you can probably tell. Taking a few extra breaths. Tommy drugged me up here. Where are we?
Hiking up Lookout Mountain, some trail. I couldn't quite read the sign because someone decided to graffiti it. But
yeah, if you're writing stuff or your name in national parks, you're an asshole. You just are. That's not an opinion. That's not me being out of line. You're a jackass.
If you can see that building straight ahead, that's around where we're parked. And then we walked all the way up the freaking mountain to here. So, yeah, it was a ways.
So many amazing views in the United States of America. So many to be discovered. It's just, it's great traveling and getting to see new areas that you haven't seen before.
The view of Denver from the top of Lookout Mountain.
Headed back down the mountain, and it goes without saying, it's a much easier trip.
Picking up after pigs. Nature is beautiful, and people should know that.
Remember, clean up after yourself, preserve nature.
It's an amazing time to be alive. Phillies Brewers tied 2-2 in the top of the sixth. I'm watching the Phillies and Brewers play on my phone on the top of a mountain in the beautiful state of Colorado.
heading down from Lookout Mountain. Got the GoPro connected to the front of the car. Let's hope this works. Otherwise, I might be down a GoPro and a whole lot of footage. Park. Should be some more great scenic views. Just walking the trail here at Red Rocks Park, checking out the scenery, which is spectacular.
It's taking a break at the Red Rock Amphitheater.
Now that was a lot of steps. Nice penny. Used to be a nice penny, now it's just a nice collectible. Back to the hotel for just a few minutes, recharging some stuff, and then heading over to the park. Just like that, back out, ready to head to the park. Taking a walk through City Park here in Denver, Colorado. Getting ready to check out the sunset. There's a nice little lake behind me. Lake, city backdrop, so figure I'll give it a try, check it out. In the hotel, that's gonna do it for tonight. Just about to relax, maybe watch a few minutes of Red Sox Astros on ESPN, have some dinner, which we hit up the supermarket. We're just going cheap tonight, eating some microwave meals that were on sale. We've got Monday coming up. Monday's arrived, gonna head out, see some stuff, and then check out Pirates Rockies tonight. Just made our first stop of the day at the National Wildlife Refuge. Looks like a pretty neat place, so we're gonna check it out. bison in the distance.
About a lot of areas in Denver is it's very loud. I don't know if it's just a string of bad luck, but the Rockies game, I mean, the music, all ballparks have music and a lot of stuff going on. They're pretty loud and rowdy, but I swear Coors Field plays the music twice as loud as anywhere else. But to get away from that, here at Rocky Mountain Arsenal Park, I found a lake here and it's nice and quiet. And really all you hear is nature sounds.
We're taking a drive around the wildlife trail, and so we're at the turnaround point, so we decided to kind of get out, take a little hike around the plains area. So it's kind of neat view, like you can see behind me, you can actually see the Rocky Mountains kind of straight back across the plains, so a nice place to kind of relax, collect your thoughts.
Was interesting. Not a ton of wildlife activity. There were some things to be seen. Definitely a nice little tour around some open land.
Just parked in downtown Denver, taking a little walk around town to check out the state capitol building and some stuff like that. Such a thing. I've noticed an awful lot of people around the city taking naps during the height of day. Here in the business center, about to purchase tickets for tonight's Pirates Rockies game.
Tickets purchased and ready to download.
Now, so you're gonna just go straight, or you're gonna stay to your right up there.
Okay.
Once the guys see your little ticket on your window, they'll show you guys where to go.
Okay. Thank right. you.
Have
Thank
a good
you.
Time.
Checking out Rockies batting practice today, and there's literally just about nobody here. Pirates are out stretching, getting prepared for today's game.
Garrett Cole, IP autograph on the Ballpark Heroes signature card. Brought to you by MTO Custom Photo.
High atop Coors Field, it's the rooftop. Check out the view. Pretty spectacular, isn't it? Show the world your free socks.
Something new to wear for softball, super manly, purple socks.
Top's really nice. It's also really windy. We just had a gust of wind come by. My ticket, which is in a bag and a half of my bag, just almost flew over the upper deck. This hat on my head, almost gone.
What'd you get?
What do you think of your newsboy cap?
Top of the morning to you.
Now you can see the CR for Colorado Rockies.
This guy dressed like Kent Tekulve is everywhere.
I swear, he's been everywhere. He's down behind the dugout, he was out in left field, guys everywhere.
Cool get up though.
Take a few minutes before the game and check out the Rockies team store. A lot of purple in here.
Solid copper, none of that zinc crap.
Destroying the solid copper. Copper.
There's the penny made into a Colorado Rockies logo. Still a little unique, still showing some of the old penny form. Destructor of penny collector. What do you think about this one?
It's kind of unique. You can kind of see on the backside, see the, you know, still see the head of the penny. You still see 1966, Abraham Lincoln. Not as shiny as some of the newer pennies, but it's got retained its character.
Submachine limit!
We're in the bottom of the second, it's still scoreless. The skies are threatening, the light rain is falling.
And we head into a rain delay.
What do you think about rain delays?
I don't know. Kind of delay things.
That was pretty quick. Rain delays come to an end. We're heading back downstairs to our seats. I can't imagine it was more than like a half hour delay. Foul ball just flew by. We're back in our seats and it's a lot brighter than it was earlier. Just the lights being on everywhere. Top of the seventh, the Pirates still hold a 1-0 lead. Inning stretch, Pirates with a 5-0 lead. Matt Joyce with a 3-run bomb to the opposite field. Called out looking, fans not happy. Head to the top of the ninth. Rockies trail the Pirates 6-1. It's our last shot. Had a great time here at Coors Field, but now it's time to head out, get back to the hotel, get stuff together, get ready to head back to Philadelphia tomorrow afternoon. That's it from Coors Field. Our friend Mr. GPS guiding us back to the hotel.
Back.
Final day in Denver begins with checking out of the hotel. I was told to really look out for the blue skies in Colorado, and then I read something about how it's blue skies like 300 days a year. Huh. Apparently I found four with cloudy skies. Waiting outside the Great Divide Brewery. Gonna go in, check it out for a few minutes.
yourself a Yeti shirt.
Got myself a Yeti shirt.
So we're just leaving Great Divide Brewing Company. It was nice to get some chocolate oak-aged Yeti straight from the brewery itself. They have a little tap room attached to the brewery, so it's a great place to try some of their beers. You can get full pours for a reasonable $5 or get some samples. Most of them are a dollar.
Right now we're looking for a place called the National Ballpark Museum. I never really heard much about it. I saw something in passing when I was looking up some stuff out here in Denver. And then I went to their website. It's really hard to tell if it's a one room thing or if it's a big thing. I know they had some stuff about the Travel Channel, so I figured we'll try and check it out. We stopped at the National Ballpark Museum here in Denver, Colorado. It's just across the street from Coors Field, and it's really awesome. Bunch of great memorabilia from ballparks of the old days. Really awesome to see. Definitely worth checking out. Is a photograph of Shibe Park, former home of the Philadelphia Phillies and Philadelphia Athletics, and here in the old turnstile. If you're in Denver, make sure you check out the National Ballpark Museum. It's awesome. Must for any baseball fan.
Prepare to depart Denver, another rainstorm hits.
Just dropped off the rental car, now next stop, airport. Security, safe and sound, no problems. Quick and easy, not too bad. Looks like it's improved in the last couple years. There was just a guy in the bathroom drinking out of the sink. Dude, just go buy some water.
Our plane has arrived and we're getting ready to take flight.
Slight delay, we were supposed to be boarding about 15 minutes ago and they haven't even started. So hopefully soon, so we can get going. Finally ready to begin boarding, so that's really good. We can start this process. Boarding time. Should be a nice comfortable flight as it will not be full, so we got three seats for two people. Some spectacular views right now. rain, which is never falling. Sun. Thank you. Have a good night. Finally back in Philadelphia. My friend Eric is kind enough to pick me and Tommy up, which is really nice considering it's like 1 a.m. Flight was delayed a little bit. Very turbulent flight, but got back safe and sound, so that's all that matters.
This live video is the taxi driver here.
That's beautiful.
I was looking over that way, and then like I thought I heard someone over there, and I'm like I think this is probably you. It was bumpy a large portion of the way. It smoothed out for a while, but like early on it was a little bumpy, and then at one point it was just, but we're sitting there for like, it's what, 3.5 hour flight. It felt like 8 hours, but it was probably like an hour and a half. And most of the time, I could care less about the snacks and the drinks, but I was just dying of thirst. All I wanted was that little cup of apple juice.
Yep.
And they wouldn't let anyone get up because, you know, everything's shaking. So I'm just sitting there. And when he came by, finally, when he got it, gone in 2 seconds. And now I'm just sucking down the ice cubes.
The ice. Did they?
And then they came back and asked, oh, would you like anything to drink? I'm like, give me another one.
Did you say?
I almost said, can I just get like four of them? Because I'm freaking
dying. Thirsty.
Home sweet home.
I've recorded so much shit in the last 4 days. It's unbelievable. It's just gonna be way too much work.
You'd make a full-length video, a whole movie out of it.